bit. Well,
look, listen.
Bit. I mean, it seems like there's no point to where we can truly be whatever it is we're supposed to be, it seems like.
Well, if we were loved when we were children, if our parents knew what love was, if the schools knew what love was, if the government knew love, if we were surrounded by love, we're not. We're surrounded by corruption from the day we're born. I'm sorry to say, even our own parents do not know how to love us, because they had parents who didn't know how to love them. And yeah. And they had great-great-great-great-grandparents who didn't know how to love them, and all the way back to when love was lost.
From the beginning.
From the very beginning, when man didn't disobey his conscience and listen to his wife, his woman, because you have listened to your woman, or the woman I've given you, or your wife, or whatever she was, because you have done this thing, a sentence of death was pronounced on the human race. We became separated from God's love, and we all began to wither away. We become animals. We become subject to the suggestions. See, there are suggestions that are within us, like Adam originally had the suggestions of his creator. He was programmed to listen, to obey an intuitive calling. Intuition has something to do with, it doesn't have anything to do with conditioning or training or culture or education. It's a knowing without all those things, without benefit of those things, like the canary and like the tiger and like the tortoise. He's a little bit slow, but he still knows how to be a tortoise, right? Right?
Yeah, I guess he can only move with...
But he knows how to be a tortoise. We don't know how to be human beings. We have to be taught everything.
Yeah, and that's what I mean. Okay, you say, okay, we have all this negative around us, and that the school, the different social programs, and all these organizations are not able to show us the right way.
They don't want to show it. They want to show us the wrong way, because the whole purpose is to make dehumanize us and make us into animals dependent on them. See, now there's war. You have to understand, young man, there's a war between good and evil going on. There's a war between good forces and evil forces going on, and man is in the middle of that.
And we're just receptors to whatever goes, to whatever influences we...
Right.
Feel, right?
Yes, we're receptive, depending on the inclination of our soul, of course. The inclination, what do we want? Do we love God, or do we want to be God? Do we want to be something other than what God made us? If we're not satisfied with what we are, if you're not satisfied with being a woman, if you're not satisfied with being an ordinary person and you want to be a king, see what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You want to make a lot of money and be a great this and a great that. There's ego involved. Wherever there's ego involved, and if ego is not involved, I assure you, the snake will come along and try to make you egotistical, to take you away from, snatch you away from the commands of God. And that's what's happened. That's what's happening in the school system. They push education. They push ambition. They push pride and egotism. And they are dehumanizing our children. Not there's anything wrong with education if it's with love, and you let children unfold like a flower. See, you lead them to the way, to their inner education, to the inner truth. Like I did with my son, see? I didn't do it with all of them yet, because I didn't know that much when they were born. I did that one with Mark because he was the youngest and I knew the most. So he had the benefit of my understanding later in life. But it doesn't mean to say that we're all finished as a result of, because our parents didn't understand us.